वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू द 32nd एनुअल जनरल मीटिंग ऑफ ऊर्जा ग्लोबल लिमिटेड थ्रू वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग एंड अदर ऑडियो विजुअल फैसिलिटी। एज अ रिमाइंडर फॉर द स्मूथ कंडक्ट ऑफ द मीटिंग, द शेयर होल्डर्स विल बी इन म्यूट मोड एंड ऑडियो वीडियो विल बी ओपन व्हेन दे विल स्पीक एट द AGM एज पर द प्री रजिस्ट्रेशन। प्लीज नोट दैट फॉर द रिक्वायरमेंट द प्रोसीडिंग्स ऑफ द एनुअल जनरल मीटिंग विल बी रिकॉर्डेड एंड अवेलेबल ऑन द वेबसाइट ऑफ द कंपनी। वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू। आई प्रियंका पब्लिक सेक्रेटरी एंड फाइनेंस ऑफिसर ऊर्जा ग्लोबल लिमिटेड वेलकम यू ऑल टू द 32nd थाइस एंड मीटिंग फॉर द भारत। इट इज अ प्लेजर टू कनेक्ट विद यू ऑल वंस अगेन। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऊर्जा ग्लोबल लिमिटेड बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स आई थैंक यू ऑल फॉर जॉइनिंग अस टुडे एट द 32nd एनुअल जनरल मीटिंग ऑफ द कंपनी। Moving further, I would now introduce the board of directors, statutory auditors, and secretariat auditors of the company. Today we have with us our respected chairman, Sir Sri Dajani Gupta, our managing director, Mr. Mohan Jagdish Agarwal, and our holding director, Mr. Yogesh Kumar Pudin. We have our engineering director, Mr. Mukul Jain, and we have Mr. Mupal Sethish, and Ms. Nivedita Sarda as independent directors. Now we have Sushil Dubey as Chief Executive Officer and Mr. Sushil Prajapati as Chief Financial Officer of the company. We also have Ms. Anubha Tiwari, our internal, and Mr. Siddiqui as Secretarial Auditor and Supervisor for the key voting process of the AGM. As the AGM is being held through video conference, the facility for appointment of proxies by the shareholders is not available, and as a proxy, register for inspection is not available. The company manages request from new shareholders to register themselves as we prioritize. Accordingly, the floor will be open for the shareholders to ask questions or express their view. The moderator will facilitate the session once the chairman opens the floor for the question answers. If we will now be heard, then I will make the next of shareholders start picking up on the money for the night side of age. The company has provided the facility, passports, fixed company, or order solutions in the league. Shareholders who have not asked you yet particularly and for your participating in the meeting, then have an opportunity to ask your votes to gain the meeting or through e-voting system provided by Seamgist. Shareholders are requested to refer to the instructions provided in the notice or appearing on video conference page for a seamless participation through video conference. In case shareholders face any difficulties, they can reach out on the any number provided by Seamgist. Shareholders may kindly note that AGM is followed. I would like to inform that members who have not voted through remote team voting can cast their votes in e-voting facility through the AGM. The e-voting facility has been enabled for shareholders to not be in a meeting, and the same shall be available until 15 minutes after the closure of the meeting. The company has appointed significant associates as to the exit, scrutinize the vote cast to meet the meeting, and the votes cast in through remote team voting platform, not CDSL, and will bear the consolidated the voting on the business most anticipatable. During the AGM, if a member is facing any technical problem related to voting by lack of means, he or she may contact on the website numbers mentioned in the notice of AGMs. The register of directors and KMTs, the register of contracts, and all other documents records with the notice are available for inspection in the temporary form. Members may inspect the same by requesting the company and CS at the relationship of the company. The remote e-voting was commenced on Sunday, 25th August 2024 at 9 AM and ending on Tuesday, 27th August 2022 at 5 AM. And the shareholders holding share as a membership 21st August 2024, which is that of day, were required to cast their votes yet for. The necessary quorum being present, the commission of chairman survey declared that the meeting is in order and given proceed to the meeting. I give now a request to the chairman to share with the overall public copy during the financial year. And my leader is my sister shoulders. Over to you, Justin.
Thank you very much, Priyanka. Good morning to all. It's my pleasure to address you and feel gratitude to your continued support, continued guidance, confidence, and over a period of time, we have increased our family to approximately 1 million Urja family. I really, its appreciation goes to all of you. In addition to that, our family has, you know, extended, including the board of directors, production facilities and other in other sectors. And so we have decided to offer 5% incentive on all our products, batteries, solar systems, electric vehicles, which is to be used in every household. You know, Bharat is growing and transition is taking place from Vikasshil to Viksit. So we have to also adopt the, you know, technological advancement, innovation, in addition to our, creativity of and in support of digitalization, we are working on a unique concept of Urja Banao, Urja Bachao, Paise Kamao, through which we are opening Urja Kendras at Gram Panchayat level, and our team is, working day and night in direction of our CEO, Mr. Dubey. And this 6P and 6E model is very unique model which we have conceived in past. 6P implies panchayat, public, private, profitable, progressive partnership. In addition to that, we are creating these centers at village level to develop the entrepreneurship skills and to develop the local resources so that it can be implemented effectively. For this implementation, we have planned to raise around $500 million USD for setting up the integrated plant, so that we can produce batteries, electric vehicles, solar systems on every place, each place. We have, in addition to Urja Kendra, we have planned to launch two more projects, Didi Ki Mahima, and another is, Yuva Jyoti. Didi Mahima is we are supporting to our sisters for women empowerment and targeted 1 million sisters to be given the e-riksha or for opening of Urja Kendras so that they can be self-sustainable and can, earn their livelihood effectively. I think this will not only be growth in the village level, but also support our activities. And I invite all of you, whosoever in your family members, relatives, looking for earnings, job opportunities, welcome. And we are creating this, created the separate platform, this Urja Kendra, B2B, B2C, so that you can directly approach online. And in Yuva Jyoti, we, because our projects are manpower intensive, we need, because the electric vehicles lijiye, yeah, you take solar systems, you take batteries, everywhere requires service, repair, maintenance, assembly, sale, marketing, lot of activities required. So we look forward that this under Yuva Jyoti, the Prime Minister has also declared that internship program. So our manufacturing facility can absorb up to 1 million students who are B-Techs, IITians, M-Techs, and this is integrated project. People generally say ki this is the different, what is the synergy between battery, solar system and electric vehicle. But I would like to explain, this is integrated model. Because, when we talk about Urja Banao, it is a generation of energy. When we say, Urja Bachao, it is a conservation of energy. Whenever the light is not there, then you can use it. And when we talk about the Paise Kamao, then this is the saving in the cost or earning through electric vehicles or solar systems. So, they make the difference that these are the different concepts, but this is all one business segment, and that's why we have put our efforts to implement it at grassroots level. So I think this is the need of the hour. And the support of green energy, electric vehicles, and the government is also focusing on Make in India. And we are also targeting that our project is viable project and your investments Your future is bright with us. Stay with us. And I request you to guide, write us whatever problems you have, whatever, you know, suggestions you have. We will implement it and we will try to be with you. Thank you very much. Now, I would like to request our CFO to explain the financials and take forward. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Dear shareholders, on behalf of Urja Global, I once again welcome you all at the 32nd Annual General Meeting. I thank you all for spending your valuable time and support us at this meeting. Let's start with the overview of our financial performance. Revenue. For this period, we reported a revenue of 44.53 crores on a standalone basis and 45.95 crores on consolidated basis, reflecting a 10% increase on a standalone basis and 11% increase on consolidated basis year over year. This growth is largely driven by our expanding footprint in and renewable energy sector, including electrical vehicles and other renewable energy sectors. Gross profit. Our gross profit reached 7.73 crores on standalone basis and 10.14 crores on a consolidated basis, with a margin of approximately 17% for standalone and 22% for consolidation. This represents an improvement of 5% on standalone basis and 4% on consolidated basis compared to previous year. The increase is attributed to higher demand for our products. Net income. We achieve a net income of 1.78 crores on standalone basis and 2.03 crores on consolidated basis, reflecting a 33% increase on standalone basis and a 31% increase on consolidated basis year over year. The net income increase is due to our higher investment in products. Looking forward, our focus will remain on driving innovation and enhancing our operation efficiency. We are excited about the opportunities and the potential to make a positive impact through our projects. We value your feedback and encourage you to share your any question or concern. Our commitment is to keep you informed and engaged as we strive to achieve our strategic goal. I now request our CEO Sushil Dubey to overview on the company performance and strategy. Thank you once again for your time, trust and support. Thank you.
Good morning all shareholders and management. I like to share our company progress and our plan. As we all know, Urja Kendra is our flagship program. It is a job generation and revenue generation program where people can earn and can do the business. We are taking Urja business to the more than 2 lakh gram panchayat, and this is our program Urja Kendra, very flagship program where individuals can do the business, become the partners, and sell our product. It's a product and project business model. And this year, this Urja Kent already progressed a lot, and we are now significantly have a presence in Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh. This expansion plan is now growing faster. And this year, we are planning more than 10,000 Urja Kent in the planning. It's generate more than 5,000 crore of revenue model. So the Urja Kendra is the flagship program where individually can get the job and the generate the revenue can the earn. So I request to all countryhood who is the willing to progress of our company can join the Urja Kendra. Apart from that, I like to announce a new scooter. High speed, we got the Chetna. Now Urja Global is not only the low speed scooter manufacturer. We got the certification, and this year we are launching 3 model of the high speed scooter. And this scooter is a fully compliant with the RTO and the homologation. So Urja, your company right now in the low speed and high speed scooter business, We are progressing in electric scooter business model. It's very fast, and we, with the, your permission and the IS company decided to raise the fund, we are planning to have the now electric four-wheeler manufacturing plant also. Apart from that, I like to share with you, we come with the now e-commerce website. Now www.urjaken.com, it's a e-commerce website. Company launched now e-commerce website where you can get all our products on the at your door. Book products, anyone can book the products, and we can deliver the products on a doorstep. So our business model now gone the progressive to B2B2B2C. We are very aggressive in a B2C business model. Apart from that, I like to share with you, with your permission, as we are going to be raise the fund, companies have an expensive plan of the expansion. Our production capacity of electric scooter of 10,000 is now, we have a plan to take it to the 1 lakh scooter, electric scooter manufacturing. This all manufacturing plant, we are going to be the integrated facility, land. Now our discussion with the government of Uttar Pradesh and the government of Rajasthan is progressing. We are in an advanced stage of the discussion to acquire the land, and this is when it's finalized, we will going to be the integrated production plant. In this integrated production plant, we took the capacity with the 10,000 electric scooter manufacturing to 1 lakh electric scooter manufacturing. We are in touch with the technology provider, and in our expansion plan, we have a 30,000 four-wheeler manufacturing expansion plan. Apart from that, as we know, we are the energy company, and now demand of the energy storage is very high. We are going to expand our lead-acid battery manufacturing capacity, and currently from the 30,000 to our new expansion plan to get the 1 lakh lead-acid battery. Apart from that, company will go to 30,000 lithium ion battery manufacturing, and we are in a touch with the technology provider for the advanced chemistry. So we are going to be the advanced chemistry lithium ion battery. Apart from that, company is this year very very aggressive in the solar rooftop. We are already the registered vendor in a many discount. Urja gone the registration and expensing the registration. Our plan to be, we are the registered vendor for the across the country, and we are touch with the MNRE to get the across the country registration for the discount, and then we will go the aggressive rooftop installation in the company. We are hand to hand with the country vision to have a 8 gigawatt rooftop installation. We are contributing on that. We, in the solar business, we come with the very advanced software. This year we purchased the PVCs and the many advanced software. So we have an in-house designing, strong designing company. And using this strong designing team, we are taking our solar rooftop business across the India. Apart from that, we are very, as you know, it's a business is a growing now. It's a outlook of the solar business is a very high. It's gone for the tenfold. So company this year have a production unit, and we are in a touch with the technology provider, and we are going to be have a solar manufacturing facility in the our integrated facility with the land we are looking with the government. As you know, the company is as not only related with the business, we are very caring to our human resources. And the company is investing in the human resources. We are training our manpower for the advanced technology. Apart from that, company have a focus on digital automation. As I want to share, I happy to share you, your company electric scooter manufacturing facility. Now it's a fully automated, and we have an automated line for the electric scooter manufacturing. And this help us to go the quality and the scope for the production. So with the, your support, with your guidance, I'm very happy to take the now new expansion plan for the company, and I taking your support for this. Over to Priyanka.
Thank you, sir, for the comprehensive coverage on the company's performance, strategy, vision, and the goals you set for us. Since there are few qualifications in the auditor's report, hence, as per SS2, the qualification of auditor's report is required to be read out at the meeting. Now, I request our auditor to read out the same.
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone, board and the members. I'm CA Anubha Tiwari, internal auditor of the company, representing Mishran Rag and Company. The statutory auditor of the company, Uttam Abuwala and Associates, had given the qualified audit report for this financial year. The qualification is based on the reversal of input and the absence of documentary evidences made available for investment in projects. As we know, for the creditors outstanding for more than 6 months, we have to reverse the input credit. So the qualification with respect to the reversal of input tax credit was highlighted for the first time during the statutory audit conducted for the financial year 2021-22. The qualification with respect to the absence of documentary evidence was highlighted for the first time this during the statutory audit conducted for financial year 21-22. The qualification regarding the reversal of input tax credit first came to our attention during the statutory audit for the fiscal year 21-22. The qualified amount of this reversal and the March 23 was reported by the company of the statutory auditor 14 crore 22 lakhs. Now, the statutory auditor has quantified the amount of the input tax credit reversal in their report for 578.28 lakhs for the year ending 24. And the reversal and the qualification regarding the document evidence available is some documents regarding the availability and ownership of the financial projects are not available to the company. These two are the qualifications in the audit report. Thank you. Over to Priyanka.
Thank you, ma'am. As the notice is already circulated to all the shareholders, with the consent of shareholders, I take the notice convening the meeting as read. Before we proceed, I am pleased to bring to your notice that as required under Companies Act 2013, the company has provided you all the facility to cast your votes electronically on all the solutions set forth in the notice. Shareholders who have not cast their vote electronically and who are participating in this meeting will have an opportunity to cast your votes through the e-voting system provided by CDSL. Shareholders may please note that there will be no voting by show of hands. Further, shareholders can seek clarification and offer comments on items of business, if any. The result of the AGM resolutions shall be declared not later than 2 working days from the conclusion of the AGM of the company. We now take up the resolutions as set forth in the notice. The floor will be open for any questions by the shareholders after all the resolutions are tabled. Moving further, we have 11 business agendas to be transacted as per the notice. I now take up item number 1 contained in the notice pertaining to adoption of the audited standalone financial statement of the company for the financial year ended on 31st March 2024, together with the report of the Board of Directors and auditors thereon. And adoption of the audited consolidated financial statement of the company for the financial year ended 31st March 2024 together with the report of auditors thereon. Moving further to item number 2, which is reappointment of Mr. Yogesh Kumar Goel as a director liable to retire by rotation. Next is item number 3, which is appointment of Ms. Nivedita Ravindra Sardhu, DIN 0093866 as non-executive independent director on the board of the company for a term of 5 consecutive years. Moving further to item number 4, which is appointment of Mr. Gopal Sethi Prasad Rao, DIN 0711-9450 as non-executive independent director on the board of the company for a term of 5 consecutive years. Next is item number 5, which is appointment of Mr. Mukul Jain, DIN
07187651 as non-executive independent director on the board of the company for a term of 5 consecutive years. Next is item number 6, material related party transactions with Urja Batteries Limited, related party of the company. The proposal is to approve the entering of the material related party transaction with Urja Batteries Limited, related party of the company, subject to maximum of Rs. 200 crores to be entered for the 3 financial year. Next is item number 7, material related party transactions with Urja Digital World Limited, related party of the company. The proposal is to approve the entering of the material related party transactions with Urja Digital World Limited, related party of the company, subject to maximum of Rs. 200 crores to be entered for the 3 financial year. Next is item number 8, material related party transactions. Sahu Minerals and Properties Limited, related party of the company. The proposal is to approve the entering of the material related party transactions with Sahu Minerals and Properties Limited, related party of the company, subject to maximum of Rs. 20 crores to be entered for the 3 financial year. Next is we have item number 9, material related party transactions with Nandanwan Commercial Private Limited, related party of the company. The proposal is to approve the entering of the material related party transactions with Nandanwan Commercial Private Limited, related party of the company, subject to maximum of Rs. 100 crores to be entered for 3 financial year. Next is item number 10, increase in overall borrowing limits of the company under section 180 and 181C of the Companies Act 2013. Last item we have raising of funds. The text of the resolutions along with the explanatory statement is provided in the notice circulated to the shareholders. Now I would request our directors to have few kind words with you about the company.
Thank you, Company Secretary. At the very outset, I would like to thank all the shareholders for being with this company, for their trust with this company. I would like to thank the company's leadership and management for their continued guidance and support. I would like to convey my sincere thanks to the dedicated employees of our company for their commitment and dedication towards the creation of an excellent enterprise. I would like to record our deep appreciation for our customers, banks, financial institutions, vendors, subcontractors, suppliers, business associates, and various government and regulatory authorities for their continuous support and cooperation, trust, and understanding. I would once again like to thank our dear shareholders for their continuous trust, confidence, and support they have placed with our company and its management. And we assure them that we will strive hard to meet your expectations. I also take this opportunity to once again thank the board members, particularly the distinguished independent directors, for providing their leadership and direction to the company and its employees. Your contribution has been significant in the past years and is going to be crucial, leading us to position ourselves prominently in terms of governance and compliance standards. With the intention to achieve higher levels of growth and success, we thank all the shareholders present here on behalf of Urja Global Limited. Now, I authorize the company secretary to conclude the meeting. Thank you. And if there are any questions you can from the shareholders, please, you can take up.
Thank you for joining our 32nd annual general meeting today and for taking time to participate in today's AGM. Before we go live with the question and answer sessions, here are some points note for your convenience. Kindly turn on your video when you are projected on the broadcast feed. Unmute yourself and proceed to ask the question. Please mention your name, folio number, location from where you are joining. Each shareholder 2 minutes for the questions. Towards repetition, the board can respond all questions for them once you have asked the questions. You can log off and continue towards the proceedings. Thank you.
All the matters have been taken up and there is no objection. So all agendas got approved. We have provided all the answers to the questions that were raised by shareholders. If there is anything that is missing or missed out, or if you have any further question, we are happy to provide such answers. Please do emails those questions anytime. We are grateful to all the stakeholders who have joined us. Thank you very much. In addition to this, I express my highly thanks to Dr. G.P. Rao, who has joined us, having the wide experience and exposure. You know, we look forward to his support in all the projects. And he has served the huge organization. So I'm grateful to you, sir. In addition to Dr. Mukul Jain, we will also, sir, express our own behalf of the board, members of the family, and, you know, members of entire team that you also joined on our request. And we will be highly get experience from your, you know, so much exposure time to time. Thank you very much, sir. In addition to that, Madam Nivedita Sarda, she is also very having the chartered accountant as well as lawyer and, you know, merit holder. So we feel also very grateful that he, on our request, she has joined as a member of the board, and you know, she will continue to guide us. And we really feel now that, you know, our board is very highly intelligent and experienced, and with these supports that our company will grow in days to come. And we put forward that our vision will be in next 5 years, 100,000 crore, a collaborate of as a worldwide known organization. So I look forward of all the members of the board, including our past Dr. Meeta Sinha, Ma'am Payal, Meeta Sinha, Payal Sharma, our CFO, our managing director, Mr. Siddiqui sir, Priyanka, all young as well as experienced. We have the, you know, sir, combination of young as well as experienced person. So I think that will be beneficial for our company. In addition to that, our, you know, workers, our management, our SEBI department, CDSL, bankers, all are, you know, time to time, whenever we require, they are there and really supportive. So we think that future is ours. As green energy sector is a focus area of the government, so future is ours. And really, the days will soon, you will see that we are on our growth path. In addition to that, the resolution has set forth in notice shall be deemed to be passed today, subject to receipt of requisite number of votes. Further, the combined results of remote e-voting and electronic voting during the AGM, along with the scrutinizer report, shall be communicated to the stock exchange within time. The results shall also be placed on the websites of the company and CDSL. With this, all the items today's AGM have now been transacted. Thank you for attending the AGM, and once again, sincerely appreciate and look forward to your continued support. With this, I declare the 30th AGM it's being concluded, and all the resolutions has been passed and declared as closed. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for next year. It's my pleasure to welcome you again. Thank you. I will pass over to Priyanka.
Thank you, sir, for making it convenient to attend this meeting, and see you next year. Be safe and be healthy.